Hi guys, this is gsnl.com and I'm here with the unboxing of the Motorola Moto G9 Plus. It's quite an interesting handset, possibly the one with the biggest screen that Motorola has ever launched. It also comes with a large battery, a quad camera and a very good price of around $200 to $250 in that ballpark. Okay, so it's unboxing time. We're going to see what's inside the box. We're going to see the extras that we're getting with this rather large handset. It feels like it's made for media consumption, so you can play games, you can watch movies on Netflix and consume music on it. It debuted in September, so it's still rather fresh now in October, and it comes in a special shade of blue and also special rose gold. As you can see in the box, we have this bundled case, which is transparent and flexible and protects the device. And this is the backside. It's a mirror-like, and from what I know, this should actually be plastic. Okay, so we've booted it up and we've already set it up so we can spare you the long process. I'm going to put the phone aside for now and let's see what else we have inside the box. Okay, so here we have, let's turn this down. Here we have the metal key used to access the slots, then a bunch of manuals and guides and juridic info. And this is the charger, which has an USB-C connector and also the promise of, as you can see here, 30 watt charging. It's also written here somewhere that it goes up to indeed 30 watts. Okay, so, and the last accessory in the box is definitely this USB-C to USB-C charger. And I know these notifications are annoying, but that's the sound they make, they've been making for a while now. Okay, so we're done with everything available inside the box. Let's pack it in and talk about its build, display, specs, and so forth. But before I do that, I actually want to mention an extra, which is available at least in my region, in Europe. People who purchase this phone, the Moto G9 Plus, will get a present. This pair of earbuds, this pair of wireless headphones, it's this model here. That's what they look like. They go in the ear like this. And it's actually a pretty nice gift to receive and a nice extra for no extra cost. So that's pretty much it. And they charge like this. And they also have the USB-C port here. Keep in mind, I'm referring to parts of Europe. I don't know if in your region this will be available or not. Okay, so putting this aside, let's focus on the actual device. It's quite big, possibly the biggest that Motorola has ever launched, and I'm talking especially about the diagonal. It's a hefty 6.8 inches in diagonal, and what you're witnessing here is an IPS LCD with a Full HD Plus resolution, and also with HDR10 support, which will definitely help you with watching videos in a wider range of colors. Now, if you want measurements, it's actually on the beefy side, 9.7 millimeters in thickness, and 223 grams in weight, but it's a pretty long phone, so these grams are pretty evenly spread throughout the length of the phone. Okay, so we have talked about the screen and the build and so forth, but let's talk a bit about the innards of the handset. Inside the phone, you'll be able to find the Qualcomm Snapdragon 730G, which you've seen last year on the Xiaomi Mi Note 10. It's an octa-core CPU at 2.2 GHz and it's accompanied by, well, 4 gigs of RAM and 128 GB of storage. There's also a microSD card slot, and one of the selling points is actually the 5000 mAh battery with a promise of fast charge at, you guessed it, 30 watts. Now, on the camera front, you can already see the punch hole here. It's a 16 megapixel selfie shooter, and if you go to the back, this module looks rather interesting. It's actually quite elegant. It doesn't protrude very much, which is always good news. We have a very generous flash here and a quad camera setup. The main cam is a 64 megapixel shooter with f1.8 aperture. Then there is an 8 megapixel ultra wide camera, 2 megapixel macro, 2 megapixel bokeh. We already used to this recipe. There's a 4K video capture and the LED flash, as well as an audio jack here at the top side. There's the fingerprint scanner embedded into the power button, which, as you can see, is working pretty fine. So let's actually use it. If you use this finger, nothing happens. If you use this one, it should be unlocked pretty fast. Aside from those aspects, we obviously have a Wi-Fi dual band. There's 4G here. There is also Bluetooth 5.0, GPS, NFC, and an USB-C port at the bottom right next to the speaker. I also want to mention an extra button here on this side. which is supposed to trigger Google Assistant, and indeed it did. And also we have these slots lined up here pretty nicely. As usual, I want to go quickly to the camera interface, and it appears to be pretty basic and pretty standard for Motorola. These are the core modes. You got your portrait, cutout, macro, spot color, night vision, cinemagraph, ultra res, live filter, and even macro video is part of the package. There's also HDR and more to be uncovered over the next days as we keep playing with the phone. We're obviously running here on Android 10. Let's actually confirm it. Android version, it's Android 10. And we have the Moto app here, which will allow you to personalize your experience, play with wallpapers, layout, try new gestures, and also use the attempted display and peak display, which replace the always on display. And even there are some features for gamers like game time and even some extra cool audio effects, which is something I haven't seen on many Motorola phones, but I'll discover as I'm playing with it. Okay, so far so good. It's supposed to be a huge device. Doesn't feel that huge in my hand at 6.8 inches. I keep reminding myself of the Motorola made Nexus phone, which had 6 inches and seemed huge. Right now we're getting closer to 7 inches, and even that doesn't seem big enough. When will we stop? Anyways, this has been the unboxing of the Moto G9 Plus. Hope you enjoyed it. It's somewhere around $200 to $250. I would say it's well worth it, particularly for the combo of CPU, large battery, and a pretty large screen. This is it from us. Bye-bye.